This screencast is related to certain physical properties of gas mixtures, specifically that of an ideal gas mixture. So the problem states that we have an ideal gas mixture at 2 atmospheres and 35 degrees Celsius. It has the following composition by volume percent. We are asked to determine the partial pressure of each of the 5 species, the mass fraction of just oxygen and carbon monoxide in this mixture, the average molecular weight of the gas mixture, and then finally the density of this mixture. So let's go ahead and start with that of the partial pressures. If we assume that oxygen has a certain amount of moles to it, and we use the ideal gas law where nRT is related to PV, this gas mixture all shares a common volume, but each component is going to have its own partial pressure. And so that's how we relate the two. What we could see that if we relate it to the total pressure, if we divide the first equation by the second equation, what we see is that the moles of oxygen over the total moles is going to be related to the partial pressure of oxygen over the total pressure. We could rewrite this as the mole fraction of oxygen times the pressure is going to be equal to the partial pressure. So what this means is for an ideal gas mixture, we could take the mole percent or mole fraction and multiply it by the total pressure to get up the partial pressure of each species, or what pressure those components therefore contribute to that total pressure. Also, for an ideal gas mixture, the mole percent is going to be the same as the volume percent. So in this case, for each of these 5 species, we could just multiply the 0.15, say, for oxygen times the 2 atmospheres, and we're going to get 0.3 atm as the partial pressure of oxygen. So going through the rest of these, and when we go through the rest of these, hopefully you get the values that I've gotten here. And we could add up all the partial pressures. So the sum of each of the partial pressures is therefore going to be the total pressure, which we know as 2 atmospheres. So that should answer part A. We're going to go to part B now, where part B asks us to find the mass fraction of oxygen and carbon monoxide in the mixture. As we're given mole percents or volume percents, we need to convert these to a mass percent, or therefore mass fraction. Now to do this, we're going to pick a basis. We're going to say that this entire gas mixture is going to be 1 mole total. What that allows us to do is use an average molecular weight formula that we learned before and multiply the mole fractions, in this case 0.15 moles of oxygen per mole total, and we're going to multiply that by our basis of 1 mole. This is going to give us the amount of moles of oxygen, which then we can multiply by the molecular weight of oxygen, in this case 32 point grams oxygen per mole oxygen. And we're going to do this for each species so that we get a total mass for our gas mixture that we assumed a basis of 1 mole. So as you can see up here, I've multiplied each of the mole fractions times the molecular weight so that I could get the amount of mass that each component contributes to our gas mixture. When we do this, you get each of the masses of each component that contributes to a total mass of the mixture of 30.42 grams. So if we want the mass fraction of oxygen, we're going to take the contribution of oxygen, 4.8 grams, divide that by the total mass. This results in a mass fraction of oxygen at 0.16, and the mass fraction of carbon dioxide, and I'm going to label that XCO, equal to 1.96 grams CO, 30.42 grams the mixture. This results in a mass fraction of carbon monoxide of 0.06 grams carbon monoxide per gram mixture. So that answers our question for part B. Part C asks for the average molecular weight of the gas mixture. Lo and behold, we've already done that. Choosing a basis of 1 mole, we've calculated what each component contributes to a total mixture. So we have 30.42 grams mass per 1 mole. So our average molecular weight of the gas mixture is therefore 30.42 grams per mole. The last part of the problem asks us to determine the density of the gas mixture. Now when we look at the density of the mixture, we know the density is some mass per volume. Now in the case of an ideal gas mixture, the best way to do this is to rewrite the mass component in terms of the actual molecular weight average of the mixture, which has the units of grams per mole. We're going to choose the molar volume, V hat, which has units of liters per mole. That way, the moles cancel, and we'll get our grams per liter. This allows us to use the ideal gas relationship, which relates the molar volume of the gas, in this case a mixture, to gas law constant R times the temperature over the pressure. So if we substitute in this to our density equation, what we see is that the density of the mixture is going to be equal to the pressure times the average molecular weight over the gas constant times the temperature. And we know all of these values, so we can just start plugging them in. Again, it's important to put all your units here so you can see what our density ends up actually being. In this case, you should get a value of around 2.4 grams per liter, or if we rewrite those in some units that might look more familiar, 2.4 kilograms per meter cubed. So does our final answer of 2.4 kilograms per meter cubed make sense? Well, if we look at the density of air at 1 atmosphere and 25 degrees Celsius, it's around 1.2 kilograms per meter cubed. So we have a density about twice of that, but we are at an elevated pressure, a slightly elevated temperature. We do have a different composition of our gas. It's not just nitrogen and oxygen.